the last question, where do you see Macedonia in, let's say, 5 years from now?
I think Macedonia would survive, even without membership. You know, do you remember what happened to Serbia? The Serbians one day said, okay, if they don't want us, we stay away. What did they do? They started to ask them, well, why don't you come? We should negotiate. And they made offers. And in spite of not having Karadzic yet, and they don't have Mladic yet, they do as if they want to integrate. Because Serbian said, no, no, if you don't like, then we don't like either. So you will exist even without membership. But if you give in and renounce on your name and tell the Bulgarians, yes, you are Bulgarians, although this is an anachronism, the Bulgarians came later than you to the Balkans. They were assimilated by the Slavs. They accepted the Slav language. They speak your language, not you theirs. It is only called Bulgarian because they managed somehow to call their country still Bulgaria and the language Bulgarian. And now they think they can pretend that Macedonia is Bulgaria. It's anachronism. It's a game. They try to realize what they had for dreams of. Velika Bulgaria, you know, Velika Megali Grecia, and Megali Serbia, and Megali Germania. I know, all the same. Megali Britannia, still today, Megali Britannia.
Yes.
Great Britain.
Yes.
Nobody cares. In my little town in Bonn, where we go very often into an Italian restaurant, Grand Italia. Crazy. But that's the case. Everybody wants to be great. If possible, super. And we have paid for that. Let the others pay too. They should renounce on becoming and wanting to be great. They should be satisfied with that, what they have. Instead of blaming and nagging other people and trying to steal their rights. They would steal your identity.
Yeah. That's a point.
Yes. And you shouldn't give in.